station on Space to Ground.
Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Leah Cheshier. This week, astronauts inside the space station prepared an external experiment that will test the ability to store fuel for future missions. NASA astronaut Anne McLean and Canadian Space Agency astronaut David Saint-Jacques prepared the Robotic Refueling Mission 3, or RRM-3, for its transfer outside through the airlock in the Japanese experiment module. RRM-3 demonstrates the first transfer and long-term storage of liquid methane, a cryogenic fluid, in microgravity. Spacecraft use cryogenic fluids as propellants or coolants, and being able to refuel while in space will be a huge boost to enabling long-duration missions to future destinations like the Moon or Mars. A suit can make anyone look their best, but it's critical for astronauts that their spacesuits work their best. Spacesuits require routine maintenance to ensure they are in proper condition before an astronaut ventures outside on a spacewalk. Spacesuits are like individual human-sized spacecraft, each containing its own portable life support system. This includes the fan pump separator, which circulates air through the oxygen ventilation circuit and transports the suit's coolant fluid. Astronauts Anne McLean and David Saint-Jacques removed one suit's fan pump separator and replaced it with an on-orbit spare, then pressurized the suit to conduct a leak check. This week's question comes from fifth grader Oliver, who wants to know if there's internet in space. In fact, the World Wide Web extends beyond the world and into space as well. Astronauts have access to what we call CrewNet, internet available on tablets aboard the International Space Station. Crew members are able to send emails, and many even have social media accounts. You can follow NASA astronaut Anne McLean on Twitter at @AstroAnimal and Canadian Space Agency astronaut David Saint-Jacques at @Astro_DavidS. Keep sending in your questions using the hashtag Space to Ground. We'll see you next week.